Welcome family, friends, and special guests to the graduating ceremony of our graduates for 2019. Thank you all for coming. Yeah. Now I would like to welcome Sister Ruth Harkins to the podium to lead us in opening prayer. Please remain standing, and those that are not, if you could stand at this time. Sister Ruth.
Thank you. Good afternoon. And we gather in the presence of our God, aware that God is present within each of us in all of creation this beautiful day. As we begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the words of the prophet Isaiah, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans for welfare and not for calamity, to give you a future full of hope. Then you shall call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you, says the Lord. You will speak to me, you will seek me and find me, if you search me with all your heart. God of mercy and compassion, today our hearts overflow with praise and thanksgiving for the countless blessings we have received during our time at Catholic University. Today, we are deeply grateful for our family, friends, benefactors who have supported us on the journey and have believed in our dream. And our hearts rejoice especially for our classmates, professors, mentors, and supervisors who have guided us with their wisdom, knowledge, and passion. And so we pray, may God's blessing follow us as you find new journeys to travel. May each of you walk safely along the pathways of your dreams. May the God of gentleness and compassion guide the decisions you will make and the passions of your heart that you will follow. And may your hearts and lives always reflect the justice, love, and truth of our God. And may hope be a light within you that you carry within you each and every day as you go forward. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please be seated. Well, good afternoon on this beautiful day here at the Catholic University of America. My name is Vincent Kiernan. I have the privilege to collaborate with the staff and faculty of the Metropolitan School of Professional Studies as the dean of the school. And I'd like to extend a warm welcome to all of you today, friends, family, alumni, as well as our honored faculty, including Mary Rory, Mary Colleen Canavas, Valentina Akaru-Bazant, Leon Hutton, Michael Kushner, Joe McDonald, Christina Strain, and Eric Fontaine. And of course, our staff and administrators and our most accomplished graduates who we are here to honor today. On behalf of our students, I would also like to honor three welcome guests, Mr. Vincent Sheehy IV, and his wife Mimi and Tricia Sheehy Malloy. The late Vincent A. Sheehy III, father of Mr. Sheehy and Ms. Malloy, was a longstanding patron of our school, generously providing financial support for many of our students, including some who are graduating today. And his family has generously continued this support after his unfortunate death. On behalf of all who have benefited from your father's unstinting generosity, we all welcome you to our celebration today. The Metropolitan School of Professional Studies seeks to assist working-age students to develop themselves academically, emotionally, and spiritually so that they can grow more fully into the special individuals that God has created them to be. With the degrees that they will receive today, our graduates will be better able to advance in their current careers or may be positioned to switch to a different career. All of us at the Metropolitan School are privileged and honored to have collaborated with today's graduates as they work toward their degrees. However, as any of these men and women will tell you, getting to this point today has not been a quick or easy journey. College coursework is rarely easy for anyone. Stir in the complications of holding a full-time job, family responsibilities, the personal demands of being a working student, and the course-by-course journey toward degree completion for non-traditional students like ours requires even more persistence and dedication. Sitting before us today, these graduates demonstrate that they have persistence and dedication, as well as intellectual accomplishment, and we are all enormously proud of them. But of course, they would not have arrived at today's finish line without the loving support of their friends, family, and coworkers, many of whom are joining us here today. Graduates, I'd ask you to rise, turn around, face them, and show your appreciation for the support they've given you to get to today. Now I'd like to invite Marilyn Brown to the stage to offer a few remarks about Dr. Vincent Sheehy III. Marilyn earned a Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies and completed her degree in spring 2019.
Good afternoon, greetings to fellow graduates, respective families, friends, loved ones, and esteemed MSPS professors and staff. I am speaking before you today because I am one of the blessed recipients of the Sheehy scholarships, as are many others of the MSPS students here today. I want to share with you my personal story and how the Sheehy scholarship enabled me to further my education. In 2014, I felt a shift in my life. I had always envisioned returning to university to complete my degree, and I interpreted the shift that I was feeling as that pull to get back to school. So I applied to CUA, MSPS, and was extremely excited about starting my first semester here at CUA. But little did I know that the shift I was feeling had more to do with my health. My very earthly existence was at stake, and I needed surgical and medical intervention. I called Joe McDonald, who was the director of admissions at the time, and informed him that my start at MSPS would have to be delayed. With genuine kindness and concern, he encouraged me and extended support on behalf of the entire MSPS team. With the will of God, the skills of a wonderful team of doctors, nurses, staff, and with the love and support of my family, friends, and job, I came through my health challenge, as they say, with flying colors. Several months later, I returned to MSPS and registered for classes. The Sheehy family was a blessing to me and many others here today. The Sheehy scholarship gave me and my fellow graduates the opportunity to continue our academic pursuit, ultimately leading us to accomplish our goals and graduate from MSPS programs. The impetus of the Sheehy scholarship was the late Dr. Vincent Sheehy. Dr. Sheehy graduated from CUA in 1951 and served on the Board of Trustees for over 10 years. In 1993, he and his family established the Sheehy Scholarship. Today, Mr. Sheehy's legacy of generosity continues through his son and family. Over 1,200 students have benefited from their generous gifts, including half of the MSPS students crossing the stage this afternoon. The Sheehy family stands as true examples of commitment to education, devotion to faith, and dedication to inspiring hope in the lives of adult students here at CUA MSPS. My heart is filled with thanks and gratitude to the Sheehy family for the opportunity the scholarship afforded me so that I could finally complete my degree. I also have deep appreciation to the awesome staff of MSPS for working tirelessly, unendingly, and persistently to create the proper environment for academic success. I am ever thankful to my family, friends, loved ones, and job. Before I close, I want to share what I believe many of you already know, and that is that the MSPS students are the best. Our time together has been supportive and encouraging. We have created a bond that cannot be easily broken. Finally, again, to the Sheehy family and to MSPS, you are life changers and life shapers. May all of your efforts be crowned with glory today and well into the future. To all, the best, and congratulations to the class of 2019.
Marilyn, thank you for your beautiful remarks. Next, I'd like to invite Matthew Morris to the stage. Matthew earned a Bachelor of Arts in Human Services Administration, summa cum laude, I might add, and will speak about the Faculty of the Year awardee, Professor Christina Strain.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Marilyn. That was an excellent speech. And I, too, am a Sheehy Scholarship Award recipient, so I extend my thanks as well. Good afternoon, Dean Kernan, faculty staff, students, and families. As you know now, my name is Matthew Morris, and it's a great privilege to be able to announce the Metropolitan School's Faculty of the Year Award recipient today. My fellow classmates and I have traveled this long academic road, and although it was not an easy road as it was filled with numerous sacrifices, such as long nights in class and weekends spent completing assignments, we made it. In the words of Nelson Mandela, there is no passion in playing small, and settling for a life that is less than one you are capable of living. I believe that each and every one of us exemplified this by returning to school and earning our degrees. So let us congratulate one another for our efforts and applaud the class of 2019. Of course, we could not have accomplished this all that we did without the excellent professors and staff at the Catholic University Metropolitan School of Professional Studies. Their patience and willingness to stand behind us certainly led us to the success. And speaking of excellent professors, it is with great honor and joy that I announce this year's Metropolitan School's Faculty of the Year Award recipient, Professor Christina Strain. So, Professor Strain was my English professor in the fall of 2015. I'd been in school for about a year. And I must admit that I was not particularly looking forward to taking my first English class in over 30 years. Ethos, logos, pathos, critical thinking, fallacies, schemes and tropes, annotated bibliographies, and research papers? No way. But Professor Strain was always so patient and ensured that I understand each concept, particularly the night we met at the Starbucks to go over my research paper rough draft. I'm not sure to this day if I've ever seen a paper where the teacher's comments and corrections were nearly as long as the paper the student had written itself. I know that all of us here today are grateful to Professor Strain for making us work hard to become better writers and better students. It has certainly made a difference in my academic journey, as I have since written dozens of papers since that time. And it is because of the skills I acquired in Professor Strain's class several years ago that I was so successful in doing so. Apart from being a professor at Catholic University, Professor Strain also teaches English at a private secondary school in Washington, D.C. Professor Strand's method of teaching focuses on providing her students with an opportunity to utilize their critical thinking skills and to allow students to engage in small group activities with each other, which allows us to grow and learn from one another. To be in Professor Strand's class is to be in an environment where you will always be heard and acknowledged as an intelligent person who can achieve greatness. By answering her students' emails, grading fairly, providing timely and helpful feedback, being totally transparent, and even meeting one-on-one outside of class, she lets her students know that indeed she cares. Thank you, Professor Strand, for your words of encouragement, your patience, and your dedication to making each of us better students than we ever thought we could be. Please join me in congratulating Professor Christina Strain. You deserve it. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Matthew, thank you for your beautiful words. It had personal anecdotes, awareness of audience, a clear sense of purpose, et cetera. But in all earnestness, it was a beautiful introduction. I'm truly humbled by such an introduction from such an incredible student. You and students like you have made these 5 years teaching here at MSPS so much more than a job. I'm both appreciative and surprised to be receiving this honor as an English teacher, considering that none of you are graduating with a degree in English. And since I feel as though I played such a very small role in your education, it is touching to know that that small role has made a difference. I want to thank Dean Kiernan for his dedication to this school, BJ for hiring me, Tony for all his support, and all the staff, especially Daniela and Twyla, who send me reminders and always work things out for me. And I'd like to thank my husband for his love and support. Most importantly, I want to thank you, the students. I wouldn't be driving to campus every Monday night after spending the day with crazy teenagers if it wasn't for you. In the class I taught this past semester on the novels of Margaret Atwood and the Me Too movement, we discussed how the context of this new wave of feminism in America has changed the way in which Atwood's novels are read. Her female characters, who are neither purely innocent nor vindictively guilty, are now understood as prototypes of victims of sexual violence and exploitation, who gain a voice and fight back. These wonderfully complex characters, no matter what context they are read in, have layers of rich meaning. But reading them in light of this particular social movement adds yet another layer of meaning. The takeaway is that context is everything. Context adds meaning, it doesn't diminish it. In the same way, a college degree, which you all have now, is always meaningful. It always carries the weight of accomplishment. But the context within which it is earned can add to that meaning. I hope you have a chance to reflect on your context. How did each of you individually get to this moment? What are the unique circumstances of your lives surrounding this degree that add a layer of meaning to it? Your contexts are the reason you are inspirational to me. You all may spend a semester learning about schemes and tropes and logical fallacies, but I get to spend my semester learning about you, about your context. Through the personal nature of an English class, particularly of a writing class where you share so much of your journey and dreams, I have the pleasure of personally studying your inspirational context. Your stories are varied, but all moving, all powerful, gritty, brave, and inspirational. I am blessed to have heard and read about the adversity you have all overcome to get to this moment. Louisa May Alcott wrote, "I am not afraid of storms, for I am learning to sail my ship." Now you have nothing to fear as you embark on the next voyage of your life because you have learned to weather the storm. Congratulations, graduates.
Beautiful, beautiful. Now, This is the time you've all been waiting for. We're now going to present the candidates for the degree programs. We're now going to present the candidate for the Associate of Science in Human Services, is Manti Sese. Manti is from Sierra Leone and migrated to the United States with her two sons in 2009. Manti worked at the Special Court with War Survivors. Manti is one of many recipients to receive the Sheehy Scholar, which helped her financially to complete her degree. And she wants to thank the Sheehy family. Manti thanks her sons, a special niece, a cousin, for their tremendous support. She would also like to thank Tony, her academic advisor, Professor Joe McDonald, and Dr. Roy for their motivation, kindness, patience, and dedication to helping her reach this milestone. Now we present the candidate for Bachelor of Arts in Human Services Administration, Erica Herrera. Erica decided to return back to school when her daughter was born. As a mother, that's all right, clap for her. As a new mother, she knew she had to set an example for her daughter, so she decided to return to school to complete her degree. Erica has earned a degree in Human Services Administration, and she hopes to better serve her community. Erica wishes to thank her parents, her sister, relatives, for helping her to accomplish this goal. She hopes to inspire her daughter and others to never give up, even when it seems impossible. You can give her a hand. Matthew Kevin Morris. Matthew Morris. All right. Matthew Morris is a service-connected, disabled United States Navy veteran from Alexandria, Virginia. While working in an inpatient drug and alcohol rehabilitation center, he was inspired to return to school to fulfill his goal of earning a degree and becoming an addictions counselor. Matthew would like to give special thanks to his parents, his wife, son, daughter, and all of the family and friends for their endless support and encouragement. Lastly, he wants to thank the staff and faculty of Metro for providing him with this outstanding education. Now we present the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts in Information Technology, Anvet Den. Anvet, known by his friends as V, was born and raised in Rockville, Maryland. While unsure at first of what he wanted to do when he first started college, being a lover of technology, he set his sights on getting a bachelor's degree in information technology. He says that he owes this moment to his parents and family members who have stood by his side and given him strength through tough times. Today, the V not only stands for his name, but for victory. All right. Theodore Rumaga. Theo, originally from the Philippines, moved to Washington, D.C. with his parents and siblings in 2005. While in high school, he was duly enrolled in an accredited university, which allowed him to excel academically. He earned his AAS in Information Technology at Montgomery College in 2017. In his eagerness to succeed, he was able to finish his BA in Information Technology this past fall at CUA. He sincerely thanks his parents for their unrelenting support and encouragement. Now we present the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies, Marilyn Brown. Woo! Marilyn is a CV technologist at Washington Hospital Center. In 2015, after her last son graduated from college, Marilyn decided to complete her degree. She attributes her achievements to the wonderful support and guidance she received from her family, loved ones, job, and of course, the MSPS family. The challenges and opportunities faced during this period have been transformative and rewarding. Marilyn would like to thank each of you for always being right there in her life when you needed her. Marilyn will be entering graduate school this coming fall. Antonia Deshae Hawkins Johnson. All right. Antonia was born and raised in Washington, D.C. After high school, she attended Trinity University. In 2006, Antonia took a break from her academic studies to focus on her family. However, in 2012, she decided to continue her education here at Catholic University, where she's been employed for the past 11 years. Upon this journey, Antonia has suffered two significant losses, her husband and mom. Though challenging, she has completed her degree. She thanks her children, which she calls them the Fab Five, her heavenly angels, her mother and great-grandmother, and everyone who supported her in her endeavors. Andrea Jacobs Cohen. Andrea was born and raised in Germany and moved to Washington, D.C. in 2003. She worked as a kindergarten teacher, and when her first child was born in 2008, she started a small in-home daycare. She's also tutored children in German, which allowed her to stay at home with her two sons. In 2015, she decided to finish her bachelor's degree, and thanks to Joe McDonald, she enrolled in CUA. Andrea feels fortunate for her experience and is thankful for all the support from her professors and her husband. Andrea is very excited to find out what her future is going to bring her. Dominique Lee. Yes. Upon arrival at Catholic University of America, Dominique was ready to study and play a key face-off position for the lacrosse team. His lacrosse playing ended with a severe concussion in his freshman season. Dominique's condition was subsequently diagnosed as a traumatic brain injury, and there started a whole new journey, many ups and downs, but it has concluded with this ceremony. Dominique's determination, the loving support and prayers of his family and friends, together with the support of the DSS team and everyone at Metro, has made a difference. The message Dominique wants to convey today is never give up, and he's excited to start a new career in finance. Josephine Livingston. All right. Josephine is a native Washingtonian. After receiving her high school diploma 49 years ago, today she's graduating a second time. The journey has been long and rewarding. While on this journey, Josephine was employed at Verizon before retiring and is a caregiver for her 95-year-old mother. Josephine gives special thanks to our father, her sons, her grands, sisters, brother, family member, and friends who supported and encouraged her. And she does not want to forget Dr. B.J. Brucker and all her professors, many who were hard, but she said they were fair. Josephine is getting ready for her next journey. All right. David Moon. David Moon is a loving husband and father to be. He is a current graduate of the Metropolitan School of Professional Studies and plans to continue as a graduate student in the MSM Leadership Program at the Bush School. Dave is the first college graduate in his family. He is a super Star Wars fan, a beekeeping extraordinaire, and an animal lover. Mr. David Moon is an educator for Prince George's County Public Schools, and his future goal is to become a school administrator or dean. Mr. David Moon. Delmi Panada. Delmi, originally from El Salvador, Central America, moved to Maryland in 1987. After completing 28 years with the U.S. military, she retired in 2016. Delmi decided to continue her education and pursue a degree in social work to serve her sisters and brothers in arms. Delmi would like to thank her Heavenly Father, Jehovah God, her beloved parents, her VA counselor, and the MSPS school for supporting her to achieve her academic goals. Delmi, if you want to give that hoorah.
Hoorah!
All right. Okay. Euclides Gordova. Euclides is from the Pacific of Colombia. He moved to Washington, D.C. with his wife and two sons in 2013. He served as a volunteer and consultant to the NGO and is a Spanish teacher for the District of Columbia Schools. Euclides at this time is pursuing studies in the master's program in social service administration. Euclides wants to thank the Almighty God, his mother, wife, children, relatives, and friends for their support and encouragement. Alexis Vigil. That good? All right. Alexis was born and raised in Washington, D.C. His journey towards his bachelor's degree took over 10 years. In that time, Alexis is most grateful for all the people he met along the way. Professors, classmates, and family always inspired Alexis to keep going. Today, Alexis is proud to complete his undergraduate degree and say thank you to all those who helped him on his journey. Now we present the candidates for the Bachelor of Arts in Management. Solomon Bassador. Solomon, originally from Mongolia, came to Virginia to visit her sister in 2013. After staying with her sister, Solomon became inspired by her sister's motivation to continue her education. Initially, Solomon started taking ESL classes to break her language barrier. After accomplishing this, she furthered her education and earned a degree in business management. Her next goal is to pursue a degree in computer science, which will allow her to combine business and programming worlds. She would like to thank her loving mother, beautiful and extraordinary smart sister for their support and encouragement. Kimberly Ann Harris. Kimberly Harris, originally from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, moved to Washington, D.C. in 1985. She subsequently joined the U.S. Social Security Administration Office of Hearing and Appeals as a legal assistant and furthered her career with the D.C. Superior Court for nearly 11 years. Although Kimberly faced many challenges, she persevered to complete her degree. She has always promoted education to her children, who now both have completed their undergraduate degrees. Kimberly thanks her family, friends, and the MSPS staff for all the love, support, and encouragement. Okay, Kudawashe Mundapa. Kuda moved to Washington, D.C. in 2004 and began a career in sales consulting. He was drawn to the Metropolitan School of Professional Studies after a decision to enhance his career. He aspires to enter the area of impact investing and contribute to the academic and professional expansion of that area. Kuda would personally like to thank his parents and siblings for their moral support as well as their exemplary conduct with education. Patrick Scroggin. Take your time. Patrick was born and raised in Washington, D.C. After struggling a few years at Nova Community College, he decided, I'm going to buckle down and transfer to Catholic University Metropolitan School of Professional Studies. Motivated by the great staff and community at the university, he was able to focus on completing his degree in business management. Patrick is pursuing his dreams and he aims to use this degree in the growing esports industry. He wants to especially thank his loving and supportive parents for always believing in him and putting up with his shenanigans, as he says. Okay, we're coming to the end. We now present the candidate for the Master of Science in Management, Kerry Smith. Kerry is a human resource professional who deeply enjoys what she does. She views her role as partnering with organizational leaders to help navigate the challenges of constantly changing external and internal environments. Kerry is also an avid community volunteer. Kerry graduated with honors from the University of District of Columbia with a degree in urban studies. She lives with her husband and two girls in Washington, D.C. Kerry likes to thank her family and close friends for their support and encouragement during this journey. Graduates, give yourselves a hand. That's right, stand. Acknowledge your greatness. That's a lot of hard work.
Well, congratulations, class of 2019. We're all so proud of you. We're coming to a close now. After we recess from the hall, we're going to re-enter the building through the admissions entrance and come back here so that our talented photographer will take some group pictures on the stage. Is that the correct?
Outside.
Outside. Believe what I'm told, not what I read. we'll do it on the stairs. Just follow us. We'll figure it out. After that, our photographer will be in here. Available to take pictures of graduates and family or any groupings that you'd like, please take advantage of that opportunity. We are happy to provide those photographs to you. Now invite Sister Ruth to come back to the microphone to offer a closing benediction as we prepare to close our ceremony.
Congratulations to our graduates. In the words of Mother Teresa of Calcutta, I pray that all those people who have graduated do not carry just a piece of paper with them, but they carry love, peace, and joy. I pray they become the sunshine of God's love to all people, the hope of eternal happiness, and the burning flame of love wherever you will go. I pray they may become carriers of God's love and they are able to give what they have received, for they have received not to keep for themselves, but to share. As you go forth this day from the Catholic University of America and from the Metropolitan School, may you have wisdom in heart and mind, hope in every challenge that you encounter, understanding to know God's will in your heart, courage to remain faithful to the passion, strength to generously share your time, talents, and treasure, knowledge to see all things with the eyes of God, and the guiding light of faith to ensure that wherever you go and whatever you do, God's love will always see you through as you care for those who are less fortunate. May your light shine before all, that they may know that God is with them as you generously share in God's love and build up the kingdom of God here on earth. And we all ask all this in Jesus' name, our brother and friend, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
So I invite the faculty to process out with me, followed by the graduates. We'll go do the photo. Anybody else who wants to take a photo at the same time is, of course, welcome to follow us. I declare these ceremonies closed.